I'd appreciate it if you would just say what you feel.
What I feel? What I feel.
We've done this before.
I feel happy. I got no problems, why wouldn't I feel happy?
You tell me, Paula. Why don't you feel happy? I think you're worried.
Damn it, Doc, you always say that. I'm not worried about anything.
There's nothing wrong with saying how you feel.
You're a pain in the ass, Doc, you know that?
If you really are happy, why do you come here for help? Paula, you aren't very responsive today. Why don't you just tell me what you're thinking?
I'm not thinking about anything particularly.
Let your mind roam. Say the first thing that comes into it.
I'm remembering.
Remembering what?
Painting?
That sounds more like a question than a statement.
Well, maybe it is. I can't help that. That's what I'm remembering. Painting.
Please say what you're thinking out loud, Paula.
I'm thinking about my mother.
What about her? Paula, what were you thinking about just then? I couldn't understand what you just said. You're taking a long time to answer. Do you think you're holding something back?
What kind of question is that? If I am, how would I know? I don't think it's that exactly. More like, there were so many things I wanted to say, I couldn't decide which.
Just take any one, Paula. Say the first thing that comes into your mind. I'm waiting.
I'm thinking.
This hasn't been a very productive session. There are only 10 or 15 minutes left. Why don't you just say the first thing that comes into your mind?
The first thing that comes into my mind is the way my mother was crying when my father died.
I don't think that was actually the first thing, Paula. Let me make a guess. Was the first thing something about hurting yourself?
As a matter of fact, Doc, I think I want to talk about my mother. You see, she wanted to get married again after my father died. Not right away. I'm not saying she was glad about his death or anything. No, she loved him all right. But I see now that she was a healthy young woman. If it hadn't been for me, I'm sure she would have remarried. I have feelings of guilt about that. I kept her from doing it. I went to her and I said, Mother, you don't need another man. I'll take care of you. Only I couldn't, of course. I was only about 8 years old.
I believe you were 9, Paula.
Was I?
Say it, Paula, please.
Say what? Christ, Doc, you're driving me right up the wall. This isn't doing either one of us any good.
Say what's bothering you, Paula, please.
Shut up.
I suggest that you try to relax.
I said shut up! I don't want to hear. I can't cope with this. Don't you understand? I can't. Can't cope. Can't.
Oh, hell, Doc. This isn't getting us anywhere. Maybe we should just call the whole thing off. I'm sure there are other people who need your services more than I do.
As to that, Paula, I can meet all of the demands on my time, but you must judge whether we continue with these sessions or not.
Have you got anything to drink?
Not in the sense that you mean, although there is a good bar down the street.
I just wonder what I'm doing here.
Hi, hon. I got it. see you working again. How's it going?
Take a look.
It'll happen. It'll happen. When you're ready. Do you remember the first time we met?
Of course. The Rhodes Gallery.
You adopted a Texas drawl and kept it up all night long. You really faked me out.
Silly, really. I just decided to be someone else. Were you really fooled?
I had no cause to doubt you. Penny for your thoughts?
Is that all my thoughts are worth?
Of course not. Do you want to talk about it?
You sound like my shrink.
Sorry, I feel like something's bothering you. I'm here, I'm listening. But you gotta start talking to me.
What if I'm sick of talking?
Did I say something to offend you?
You haven't done anything. You're pushing me, Larry. Stop chasing me for answers.
You know, most women complain that their men never listen to them.
What do you want, a medal?
No. Maybe you're right. I'll stop pressing you.
So you still cling to that preposterous notion?
Absolutely. No beginning, no ending, a complete justification of one's existence.
Painting circles, my friend, is just a starting point. The egg before it hatches, if you will. You must look at the bigger picture. What's the next step?
Oh, God, abstraction. Don't tell me you're getting into that. Heaven can't be found in geometry, my friend.
Heaven is standing on the beach with your man by your side.
I don't want to hear that. Circles are geometry, but they are just a launching point. How does color figure into it? The mixing of materials?
Throwing paint at a canvas is not the solution. Paula, you tell her.
I'm in no position to judge anyone. I seem to be crippled creatively. For all I know, throwing paint at a canvas may be the answer.
The picture is always clearer when you stand back and see the whole thing. Your creative drought may be a blessing in disguise.
I still say the answer is elsewhere. But try painting them, Paula, if you must.
Now why should I walk Ed's side of the street?
Especially when your street is empty and blocked with dead ends.
Oh, what a wit. Sharp as a circle.
Here comes your agent, Paula.
You really have it made, my dear. I can't get mine to give me the time of day.
Can't blame him. We all know that time is of no value to you. Just another label of abstraction.
Very profound.
Well, if you gentlemen will excuse me.
Wow, Paula, am I late?
No, I thought we should go for a walk. Aaron and Ed are inside.
Don't tell me. The old circle argument?
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's walk.
Not that it makes a difference, but Virginia Collins nearly lost her assets when I described your latest work to her.
My latest work is 2 years old. You know, I haven't really thought about art ever since my mom died.
Here, the contract papers from Collins herself. You just make 12 new pieces.
12?
Yes, 12. It's your chance to be the biggest thing in the art world, again.
Marty, I love you dearly, but I really feel you don't know me at all. Why are you willing to risk your reputation on me?
Don't flatter yourself. There's a lot of money to be made on this. Think of your future, of Larry. Think of me.
But 12 pieces? I can't even begin to paint.
Stop thinking so hard, Paula. Just go with your guts or instincts or whatever the hell it is you draw inspiration from. In the end, just do what you were put here for.
Marty, I don't even know who I am anymore.
Good. Keep talking like that. Madness makes great art.
Very funny.
Let's face it, you're the closest thing to art I'm ever going to get.
That's the most personal thing you've ever said to me. You must be desperate.
If you want, I'll step aside as your agent.
You know I couldn't do it without you, but that's very sweet of you.
And so, my dear, comes down to this. Can you do it? Are you up to the challenge?
I've got to be. I can't just keep running forever.
That's the spirit. Life's streets narrow down after a while. Sooner or later, there's bound to be a dead end. But in the art world, you've got the starring role. Play it.
Maybe that it would do me good if I believed there were a God out in the starry firmament. As it is, it's just a lie, and I'm here eating up the boredom on an island of cement. Give me your ecstasy, I'll feel it. Open window and I'll steal it, baby, like it's heaven sent. This ain't no love that's guiding me. Some days I'm bursting at the seams with all my half-remembered dreams, and then it shoots me down again. I feel the dampness as it creeps. I hear you coughing in your sleep beneath a broken window pane. Tomorrow, girl, I'll buy you chips, a lollipop to stain your lips, and it'll all go right as rain. This ain't no love, it's guiding me. This ain't no love. Like a thousand diamond buds waiting there in every pause, that old familiar fear that claws, it tells you nothing and no good. Pulling back, you see it all down here, so laughable and small, hardly a quiver in the dew. ain't no love that's guiding me.
What's the matter, Paula?
Nothing. Funny, I don't even know how I got here. I must have fallen asleep or something. You never believe what I just did in the dream.
What did you do?
I feel pretty foolish, Doc.
Is there some way I can make you feel more comfortable?
You can drop dead.
Just relax, Paula. It's all right.
The hell it is.
You were going to tell me about your dream.
You bore me, Doc. You really do.
What was the strangest dream you can recall?
Strangest?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to tell you. It's weird. Besides, you'll read too much into it.
Will I? Why don't you just tell me about this strange dream? Don't fight it. Just describe what appears in your mind.
It's a dream I've had many times. And each time, it's exactly the same.
Continue, please.
I don't know why, but in the dream, I'm a man. But it's still me, understand? Only I'm called Paul, not Paula. I'm still an artist. And I'm at some fancy party being held in my honor. This is stupid. I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Are you uncomfortable because you're a man in the dream?
Who knows? What's it supposed to mean? That I was a man in a former life? Or I wish to be a man instead of a woman because we all know it's a man's world out there?
Please, don't try to make sense of the situation. Dreams are full of symbolism and are open to interpretation.
In the dream, I'm surrounded by all these people who think they know art. And me. They really don't understand anything at all. I'm feeling dizzy.
Are you all right, Paul?
Just a little dizzy. I'm okay, thanks.
Forget abstraction. Paul's work will capture the eye from at least 50 feet away.
I thought the artwork was brilliant. It called to mind a poem by Robert Frost, where he says, what does he say? He says, we dance around a circle and suppose, but the secret is in the center and knows.
It's wonderful.
You need authenticity. A real work of art is handled so well, you don't question.
An answer has answers.
You can't put everything down on a canvas. Only God can do that.
You need order, a sense of the way things should go.
Yes. It's not about feeling. Art isn't about feeling, it's about reason.
Like, well, simple reason. It's about the dynamism of the artist.
I don't think that color would look better with a smaller frame or a bigger frame, as you say. But I guess it's up to the artist to decide.
Go back to art school, that's my recommendation.
Thank you.
There's the man of the moment now. A true visionary.
Yes.
One look at this man's work and you will see what we all know. That it is timeless.
Yes.
Timeless.
Yes.
Then visionary.
Yes.
And created from the soul itself.
Oh.
Yes. Yes. To Paul and his fabulous artwork.
To Paul.
We've really made it this time, my friend. Virginia Collins herself buying and sponsoring your show. This is what we have, I mean, what you've always wanted. How is this possible? What show is this?
What work have I done?
That's what I love about you, man. Nothing, no turn of events changes you. What show, indeed. You artists are all alike. You must give credit for some sense of obligation.
This is insane.
Perhaps, but keep it up. We're on a course with destiny. And here she comes now.
Come on, Paul. Tell us what's next, darling. Tell us what's next for the madman. Oh, I would take it all back, but then one can't do that, can one?
Not hardly. It's all too fast, Miss Collins. It's all...
There goes Wanda.
What did you say?
I said, there goes Wanda. That woman over there. She's on her way to steal artists from me. She doesn't even want what she takes. Gives most of it away. It's an obsession with her. She's trying to get back at people for God only knows what. Yeah. People do funny things, don't they, Paul?
I suppose that could be true.
Nobody heard me tell you anything, did they?
Not a soul, Miss Collins. Not a single solitary soul.
You look pale, Paul. How are you feeling?
I'm having a bad dream. But I'm all right.
Good, good. It's in here. Oh. Hotter than hell. I'm glad this place is air conditioned. Good for the art as well.
My work is here?
As if you didn't know. Darling, your work is in the next room. After all, I am the somebody who went to a lot of trouble to rig things up for you.
And we are all grateful, Virginia. Paul wasn't making any prejudgments about anything.
If only they knew how close you really are, Paul. I think you have the touch of the genius in you.
I very much agree.
It must be frustrating for you, not being able to do something when one knows damn well that it should be done. I hope we haven't disillusioned you in the manner in which we go about things.
No, you haven't disillusioned me. That happened a long time ago. Would you excuse me for a minute or two? I'd like to go see my show.
Yes, of course, certainly. You go straight out and make a right. Enjoy it, Paul. I want you to make yourself at home.
Thank you.
Well, one does have to pay attention.
Yes, of course one does. They could sneak something past you if you didn't.
They sure as hell could.
I have no doubt whatsoever. Excuse me.
Feel lost. Something's going on here. Have I been here the whole time?
Where else would you be?
You're playing with me. I'm getting angry. What does that mean?
What do you think it means, Paula?
If I knew, I wouldn't have to ask you. I wonder. Am I trying to cop out?
Getting angry because you're getting too close to something?
Please, don't think about the process, Paula. Just tell me how you feel.
Guilty.
Guilty about what?
Doc, as shrinks go, you're great. And I enjoy these sessions in an intellectual way. But I wonder if we've gone about as far as we can go. You're just stirring up old, unnecessary pain, and frankly, I don't know why I let you do that to me.
Your life and dreams are full of pain and questions, Paula.
So that's how I'm built. I don't have the answers, and I'm beginning to think you don't either. Maybe I hate my father because he died and deserted me. Maybe I secretly wish I was a man instead of a woman. So what?
I know you're being rhetorical, Paula, but the way to deal with these things is to get them out into the open.
For what? To make me hurt?
To let the inside hurt come out where you can deal with it.
Maybe it would be simpler all around if I just made up my mind to go on hurting a little bit inside. I'm not denying I've got something out of these sessions. There are times, Doc, when we get through with a session and I really get a lift out of it. I go out of here with my head full of new thoughts, and the sun is bright and the air is clear, and everybody seems to be smiling at me. But not lately. Lately, I think it's boring and unproductive, and what would you say if I told you I wanted to pack it in?
I would say it was your decision to make, Paula. It always is.
Well, maybe I'll just do that.
Paula, why did you say you felt guilty?
I guess it was just a slip of the tongue. I really do have to go now, Doc.
Your life and dreams are full of pain and questions. You're clinging to the edge, the utmost limit.
Excuse me?
You can fly too if you really want.
The optimist proclaims that we live in the best of all possible worlds.
The pessimist fears that this is so.
Life is the art of drawing sufficient conclusion from insufficient premises.
Remember your great philosophers.
The more terrifying the circumstances of life, the better for man, so that his freedom, power, and imagination can be tested to the breaking point. If you're capable of becoming a man.
And the danger and harsh judgment of existence on your thoughtlessness will help you become one.
Did the doctor send you?
When is a straight line not a straight line?
Space is curved and there are no truths outside the great gates of Eden.
Thought, feeling, and the imagination are at war. The task is not to annul one at the expense of the other.
On the contrary, to preserve their equilibrium, their simultaneity, they are united.
On the plane of existence. We are involved in a life that surpasses understanding.
Existence precedes essence.
Sit down, honey.
Yes, don't just stand there. Join us.
Paula has nobody to blame but herself. But she's here now. That's what's important.
Exactly. Some wine, honey?
Yes, thanks. Is there something about this picture that doesn't make sense?
Tell me when.
The only thing you have to worry about is Mr. Devilman.
That's true.
Who in the hell is Mr. Devilman?
Very funny, Paula.
Mr. Devilman's a neighbor in this area, and he has a right for a little peace.
He's paid his dues, and if I were you, I'd watch what I say about anybody.
He's right, honey. You know, we don't want to get kicked out.
I would appreciate it if somebody would tell me what's going on.
What are you going on about, Paula? Just enjoy the meal and stop worrying.
Good. Then it's all settled.
The hell it has.
Oh, I think it's all working out fine.
So have you shipped out your work yet?
My work?
I've arranged for the shipping of the paintings. Paula's work is heavenly. I've arranged the negotiations, the preparations, and...
I'm sorry, Marty.
Sorry? Sorry for what?
But you know, Paula, an agent's life is hard.
An artist's life is hard. It's a lousy existence. Don't you understand what I've been going through?
We all understand, dearest.
You know, when I had been discovered by the art world and was given all those honors, I should have walked away. But it was nice to get the attention. It's what I thought I always wanted. But you know what? All it did was open wounds I never knew I had.
All of us carry wounds, Mom.
Yes. Just by living. In fact, your wounds are the proof that you're still alive.
I'll admit that experiences can leave marks on our lives that are a testament to how we've lived. But not all of them are good. Some, in fact, kill your soul.
Some believe that good art is the result of suffering.
I hate that whole process. Should the artist be the art, live the art? Is that, in fact, living at all? I used to think I was an artist. But the older I get, the more I find myself hating the art.
Then why don't you quit?
Quit? How can I quit? Why don't you try painting? Find out what it's like. I have to keep my sanity, and that means trying to figure out what in the hell to do next. Sometimes I just don't feel like myself anymore.
Who are any of us, really? Nobody really knows themselves, or they only think they do.
I feel like I'm chasing my own tail.
You need to get some perspective. We'll help you, my dear.
Forget it. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be accusing you of anything. You didn't do anything wrong. It's nothing. I don't know what I get myself so worked up about anyway.
Because it's important to you.
Yes. And I'll paint again. You'll see. Art is suffering. Then I'm ready.
Here's to Paula.
Here's to Paula.
Drink, Paula. You'll never taste better wine than this.
It's good.
All right, let's keep everything pleasant.
I'm feeling very pleasant.
How are you feeling, Paula?
Better now.
Excellent. See how some things are temporary? Your spirit reminds me of St. Elmo's fire.
It's just static electricity.
But it's what it does. It bounces around all over the place and brightens things up even as it's going out.
I see what you mean.
I'm feeling very pleasant.
No, you don't. You don't see a damn thing, my dear. You really gotta get out there and see and know. You really gotta get out there. You really gotta see and know. Get out there. No. No.
What's the matter? What's the matter? You're not ill, are you?
You looked whiter than a ghost there for a minute.
This is supposed to be a party, not a funeral. Give her a break.
I'm all right.
That's a good girl. Get a grip.
She's fine. A little rest would do you good.
Not gonna keel over on us, are ya?
No way. My girl's got a long lifeline.
The point is, everybody has a breaking point. But what happens when we pass our limits? I mean,
We're not children anymore, are we? We can't keep on running from things.
You're right, Ed. I should take care of myself. Too many people talk themselves into madhouses. Not a typical thing to do. Not difficult at all.
Glory be. Hooray for Paula. She finally discovered a truth.
But is it enough to see the whole picture?
I'm not stupid. I can't explain what's going on, but everything is wrong.
Like what?
This dinner, this gathering. I mean, I don't know where I am or why you're all here.
Can't friends just get together?
And help each other?
Yes, of course. But why won't somebody tell me what is going on?
We have...
What don't you understand?
You're having a bad dream. You're at home, in bed.
I am?
Go back to sleep.
Hi, hon. Hi, Dad. So you're working again. How's it going?
Take a look.
It's all right. It'll happen. What are you thinking?
Something is going on. I'm not sure what it is or how to explain it.
Is it about us?
It's about me. I'm not well.
Do you need to see a doctor?
I need some air.
Well, let's take a walk.
What do you want?
Want? I don't want anything.
Well, that's not exactly true, is it?
What do you mean?
We all want something. Even me.
Are you going to hurt me?
Hurt you? You came to me, remember? No, I'm not the one you have to worry about.
Then what are you talking about?
You're thinking it would be best for everyone if you just went away. And the sad truth is you're making it happen.
Who are you?
I'm just an artist.
What if I told you I don't believe you?
It won't change anything if that's what you're thinking.
What are you drawing?
Why do you ask?
Because I'm curious to see what interests you.
What would you be drawing if you were here?
I don't see anything.
You don't?
Why? What do you see?
I see someone who is turning a blind eye to art.
Because I don't see anything?
Exactly.
You know, I just about had it with everyone. All you do is talk nonsense, giving me some psycho babble that's supposed to mean something, but adds up to nothing. I'm not playing this game anymore.
You know what I hate? I'll be out here with my canvas, paints, and easel. Someone will walk up to me and say, "Are you an artist?"
It's happened to me. Thank you.
For what?
For making me laugh. It's been a long time since I felt happy. I thought I'd lost my sense of humor. I need to get it back. Which reminds me.
Yes?
Reminds me when I was young. I remember my mom bought me these expensive sneakers. I told her I didn't like them, but she didn't listen. She never really listened to me. But she made me wear them despite my complaints. One day I decided to walk home from school instead of taking the bus. It wasn't a long walk, just a couple of miles. But it was something I needed to do. I remember looking down at my feet while I was walking. I kept thinking how much I hated these things on my feet. Anyway, as I was nearing my house, I stopped suddenly. I sat down, I took them off, I got up, and I started walking, holding my sneakers, and then...
And then what happened?
I had an impulse. I threw my sneakers straight up into the air as hard as I could, and they never landed.
Never landed?
I looked up and saw my new sneakers hanging from a telephone wire that stretched across the street I was on. I knew I could never reach them. They just hung there, swaying in the air.
And how did that make you feel?
You sound like my shrink. How did I feel? Free. I felt free. I needed to do something, and I did it. And for some reason, it was the funniest thing in the world. I never laughed so hard. Man, did I get into trouble. But I didn't care. I'm glad I did it.
Perhaps you see more than I gave you credit for.
Can I see what you're drawing now?
It's not finished yet.
That's all right.
It's just a still life.
But it's blank.
Yes, it's nothing, really.
But what's the point? Nothing is an abstraction. Why is it so important to capture the impossible?
Tell me, can you really not see what's there? We're artists. We're able to see what others cannot.
To have lost my sight.
We'll fix that! Happy birthday!
Thank you.
Oh, we got her.
Good. Congratulations.
How are you?
Good job.
Delicious.
Oops.
Can't wait.
Oh, it looks very good.
Wow.
She got the pink rose.
Oh. All right, who forgot the ball?
Yeah, really nice.
Cheers
for Bola!
Just putting it together, make sure the whole fitting right is the best. That's how you want it.
Well, essentially, everything you see is just made up of very
easy. Yes. But I'm into the more angles.
Yeah.
I want people's eyes to get lost in it.
Subjected that to it once too many times.
England.
I've seen it all. Seen it all. Heard it all.
Been there.
From that.
Yeah. Really nice.
Last time I went to Paris.
The leaves of memory make a mournful rustle in the dark.
It's Longfellow, isn't it?
Yes.
Are you having a nice birthday, Paula?
Yes.
Are you all right, Paul?
Just a little dizzy. I'm okay. Thanks.
And you will see what we all know, that it is timeless and visionary and created from the soul itself.
Beautiful.
To Paul and his fabulous artwork.
To Paul!
We've really made it this time, my friend. Virginia Collins herself buying and sponsoring your show. This is what we have, what you've always wanted.
How is this possible? What show is this? What work have I done?
If only they knew how close you really are, Paul. I think you have the touch of the genius in you.
I very much agree.
It must be frustrating for you, not being able to do something when one knows damn well that it should be done. I hope we haven't disillusioned you in the manner in which we go about things.
No, you haven't disillusioned me. That happened a long time ago. Will you excuse me for a minute or two? I'd like to go see my show.
Yes, of course, certainly. You go straight out and make a right. Enjoy it, Paul. I want you to make yourself at home.
Thank you.
Well, one does have to pay attention.
Of course one does. Or they may slip something past you if you didn't.
They sure as hell could.
I have no doubt whatsoever. Excuse me.
It's all right.
I need a ride, but I'm not sure where I'm going.
But I think you do. Shall I take you there?
Where are we going?
You mean, where are you going? Driver, take us to where Paula wants to go.
I want to go home. I want to go home.
Everybody does. At the end of a long working day, or at the end of an adventure, home is where everybody wants to be.
I hate being lost, and I hate not being in control.
You know, I've discovered that control is an illusion. It's just circumstances that build up to the point where you think you don't have control. It's a mere illusion.
Are you an illusion?
I certainly hope not. Don't you know who I am?
Yes. You're Wanda, famous art collector, rival to Virginia Collins.
Well, my reputation precedes me. But I suppose it could be worse.
My work is an illusion that everybody sees but me.
I find that very hard to believe.
What would you know about it? You just want to add me to your collection.
Is that so terrible? You paint beautiful things, and I collect them.
I'm very tired.
I know you are, my dear. But I do have some advice for you. That is, if you want it.
Sure, I guess.
The problem with life is that its back roads are never properly taken care of. And what starts out as small depressions end up becoming big potholes. So what can you do? Don't regret anything, mistakes included. And here we are. Driver, stop here, please.
Where are we? Do I owe you anything?
You don't owe me a thing.
Thank you.
I've been expecting you.
You have?
They say, if you travel far enough, you run into yourself.
If you know anything about what's going on, please tell me.
Would you like a drink?
Yes, thanks. You mean?
Where am I? You?
This is better. Fresh air.
dream? A riddle? Another existence?
Yes. Or no.
What is going on?
If you're looking for some simple answer, I don't have one.
Nothing makes sense anymore. How can you be me? And yet my gut tells me we are the same person.
Well, I'm flattered.
I'm serious. I don't know what's real anymore. I'm losing my ability to know who I am.
Let me try to help us. If this is a dream, and you're having a nervous breakdown, then nothing I can say will be the truth. I might be a part of your mind, trying to rationalize its way out of a bad situation. Or maybe we were twins, and one of us didn't make it completely, and we share an existence. Or maybe I am you, from a former life that you weren't supposed to remember at all. You see the dilemma?
So what happens next?
I'm not sure. But I've been experiencing life through your eyes. And I suspect you've seen through mine.
But why? Why is this thing happening to us?
Maybe this is the way things are. No person is made up from a single thing. We just feel we're one entity. Somehow you and I have been separated. Or maybe because we're artists, we see things more clearly than other people.
I've gone insane. I'm trying to make sense out of something that's out of my hands.
I don't think we're crazy. I feel that we're being manipulated, but by who or what, I can't say.
What would you say if I thought we were in hell? That we'd killed ourselves and now we're being punished?
If that were true, don't you think we've suffered long enough?
Yes, I do. I have to be good to myself. It's not too late.
We have been sad a long time. But it's time to take a look at the good things around us. To face the truth at last. At least until we meet again. And again.
But how can we face the truth when we don't know who we are? Which one is the real me? I mean, us.
I can't explain this to you with words I have, but try to understand. I feel I've lived as long as I can as me. But you have a much longer journey ahead of you. And the best thing I can do for us, for you, is to take a leave of absence from existence itself.
I can't let you do that. What if you're the real me and I'm the dream?
There is no greater love than self-love. We're traveling in the dark, and I have to help me. Live your life. It's yours to use. Whatever I've given you. Or you can cease to be. The choice is yours.
Thank me for what, Paula? I don't understand. What?
You seemed to doze off and then suddenly you thanked me. Do you remember why?
I can't think. I thought I knew. This isn't going to be a very productive session today, Doc. I'm just plain exhausted.
Do you remember any dreams, Paula?
No.
I think you know, Paula, that everyone has dreams. You may not remember the dreams in a waking state, but you can if you try.
No, I can't.
Will you try an experiment?
Maybe.
It isn't hard. Keep a pen and paper beside your bed, and as soon as you wake up, write down what you remember.
I hardly remember anything at all about my dreams.
I think it's worth a try.
Can I ask you a question, Doc?
Can't you always, Paula?
Well, what I want to know is, what do you do with the things I tell you?
I'm not sure I understand the question, Paula.
You got your own problems. And here I am, unloading
onto you, along with all your other patients. Where does the pain go? You see, Doc, if I give you my pain and you give it to someone else, it has to end somewhere.
I don't think it's profitable to discuss the nature of pain with you, Paula. What I do with my pain may satisfy your curiosity, and it may also provide you with an excuse to spend these sessions on intellectual conversation instead of therapy.
Touché, Doc.
Yes, but it is what you do with it that makes a difference, and whether you feel somewhat better or somewhat worse in situations that are important to you. Concern yourself with the inside of your own head, Paula, not mine.
You sure are one intellectual mother, Doc.
I have the impression that what you're actually saying is I hate your guts, Doc. I think that's enough for today, Paula. Same time next week?
Yes, of course. Thank you.
This is it! This is it. Now remember what I told you. Pace yourself, and on the last lap, let it all go. Loosen up, Paula. Loosen up. Now remember what I told you. Now what are we going to do?
Run?
Yes, yes. And then what?
What do you mean?
Well, what do we do after?
Am I running from something or to something?
Yes.
Which is it? I don't understand.
That's my girl. I knew you'd get it. There's ambition. There's circumstance. Watch out for her. That's reflection. And over there is opportunity, right next to accomplishment.
You've got to be kidding.
Ignore them. Just run like the devil. And remember, the track is a circle. Be careful you don't end up where you started from.
Isn't that the point?
What are you waiting for? Do it! One more step and you've won! Move! Move! Move!
Do you think you should?
No, I won't do it.
That's your problem, isn't it? You never finish what you start, do you? Are you afraid of winning? Of accomplishing something? Of dying? Of losing your soul? Is that what your problem is?
Yes, it's my problem. It's everybody's problem.
It's heavenly.
What'd you say?
I said, it's heavenly.
So may the truth is alone. I'm weighted down with love. Snow lying deep and even. Strung out in dreaming of night falling on the city, quite something to behold. Don't it just look so pretty? Let's disappear. sparkling red and gold. Girl, don't it look so pretty, this disappearing world, this disappearing. Disappearing.